Whenever we used to have a birthday for an adult, my mum would always go to the shop and get a Blackforest cake.
Yep.
Did you like them when you were young?
It took, I'm going to admit, it took me a while to warm up to the old Blackforest, but now I dig them.
They're so good, aren't they? Yeah. And now I think they're a cake that is probably, it's been forgotten about a little bit.
And abused, I think, as well.
Yeah, you get a lot of bad ones. Yeah. So we're going to try and deconstruct one. Same sort of flavours that would go into your Blackforest cake. I'm going to add some avocado to our chocolate mousse, though.
Nice.
Something a little bit different.
Yeah.
Welcome Andy Allen as well. I forgot to add that bit in.
You always forget.
Back in the kitchen. And we're doing dessert. Dessert isn't something we normally do. Are you enjoying desserts more since MasterChef? Because you didn't make a lot of them when in our season.
I was scared of them when I was on MasterChef because I didn't know much about them at all. And I've learnt to have a play, and that's what I'm really enjoying.
And I think desserts have gone more down our path more, where they're being more savoury, more complex.
Yep.
Which sort of fits in with, for the first 3 years I knew you, you never ate dessert.
No.
Vanilla ice cream is about as far as you went.
Yeah.
But now...
because I don't have a sweet tooth.
Yeah.
And I always thought that desserts were sweet, but I was totally wrong.
So I've brought him over to the dark side. Sugar.
Speaking of dark side, got a few nice little dark chocolate bits here.
Yeah, so melt them down for me, pop them in.
We're going with 100.
100 grams of our dark chocolate. And you could just go completely 150 grams dark chocolate if you wanted to. Mm-hmm. And that's probably what I would do. But for people at home, I reckon 50 grams of milk chocolate.
Yep.
Add a little bit of sweetness. Probably a little bit more smooth. Not as bitter as the dark.
Yeah, and we've just got that over a double boiler. The water, make sure it doesn't touch the bottom and it's just simmering away. It's not furiously bubbling. We just want it ticking away.
And then I want to put about 100 grams of sour cream in there. Take our Avo.
Yep.
Now you want a nice soft one for these things. When you're testing, how do you test for the softness or ripeness of an avocado?
I don't know.
I always squeeze here.
Yeah.
You want some movement there.
Squeeze.
I reckon if you squeeze there, so if you feel the top bit compared to the middle bit, because there's that massive stone in the middle, it gives you a warp sensation.
I'm learning every day.
So we'll cut him open, scoop him out. You've got a spatula so you can just bring that down.
Big thing with your ganache is just let it go. Let it go for a bit. Don't go in there all the time and start moving everything around. So let it go, let it melt down and then mix it all together.
Yeah. And if you've got a lot of dark chocolate in there, it's not going to split. You're really safe with dark chocolate, aren't you? And then into our little food processor. I'm going to put two avos in. So we've got a fair bit of chocolate there.
Yeah, yep.
And if you're going to make it in a big batch. We're going to put it in a piping bag so you can keep it in the fridge for a good long time.
And I would think two things that are going on here, both the chocolate and the avo, love salt. So you're going to put a pinch of salt in, a little bit of acidity with the lime.
Absolutely.
And then get it all together.
Yeah, and that's exactly what we were talking about before, about dessert isn't just about sweetness anymore, is it?
No, not at all. It's actually more towards, you know, the pumpkin sorbets, you know, avocado ice creams, nice shot.
Yep.
Did you get that was one good. There? I guarantee I'm going to make a mistake later, so I'm going to get you while I actually can.
I love it when you take the mickey out of me because it just sets you up.
Doesn't happen very often.
All right, so cheek of a lemon or lime. So basic rule, as a lime goes through its maturing process, it actually goes more yellow. Mm-hmm. So if you get nice yellow limes at your greengrocer, they'll be nice and juicy.
You've got more juice. Don't be put off by the colour.
Yeah, good pinch of salt, like you said. And then I'm just going to blitz that all up. Lid on. And making an avocado mousse is simple because it's just combining your chocolate and your avocado and blitzing it.
And you want to take the time to get this pretty smooth, yeah?
Yeah. Yeah, you want the mousse to be nice and smooth.
To be nice and smooth.
And that's why you want a really ripe avocado.
Yeah.
So you can break it down, it will be really smooth. Avocado's got lots of fat, so it's got sort of the same fat content that chocolate has got.
Yep.
So it's going to come together really quite well. All right. I'm pretty happy with that.
Mm-hmm.
Once that chocolate melts and comes together, we'll add that on top, blitz it again, piping bag in the fridge. Our chocolate mousse has cooled down a bit in the fridge, and then the leftover sour cream I put in another little piping bag just to make it easier to plate up.
I'm excited because we've got the bones of a really nice dish here. That chocolate mousse, I had a little sneaky taste before. It's really, really good.
Nice.
It's really good. Not that I doubted you, but it's really good.
You always doubt me.
And now we go to town on the plating.
Yeah, and we know their flavours at work. So first thing I'll do is I'll just pipe a little bit of the sour cream into the bottom of this plate.
So I will let you know, you can throw all this and make it look like a dog's breakfast and it would taste absolutely stunning.
Yeah.
We're just gonna have a little play, yeah?
Yeah, pretty much. It's just, we'll see what it ends up being. Yeah. I would have just thrown it all into a glass and then eaten it out
of
a glass.
You don't need to impress me. That's fine, I know you can cook.
I try to put on a show when you're here. All right, so mousse in now, mate. What I guess I've tried to do is, with the Black Forest cake, it's a surprise on the inside with the cherries in it. So underneath our mousse, we'll have this little surprise of the cream and the...
So now, I'm gonna try and just go like that.
Oh, yeah. And then, that's what you want.
Just give it a little tap, so that all those
so it's all hidden underneath. Covered. Oh, so I'm going to put on some more cherries, ones you can actually see now.
While you're doing that, I'm just going to get our little biscuits into our mortar and pestle, crack these up, just so they're like, dare I say it, a soil.
Yeah, soil, sand, gravel, gets called lots of things on menus now, doesn't it?
Gravel.
Gravel, chocolate gravel. Imagine if you saw that on a menu 5 years ago. So a nice little coating of the cherries. For me, with a Black Forest, the cherries are the best bit, so do not skimp on these cherries, Morello cherries. So
now,
that's on there.
We're gonna go in with our crumb,
yeah.
Is that right?
So this is your texture. Oh, yum. This is gonna be a good dish.
I think so, yeah. I didn't doubt you at all.
While you're doing that, I'm gonna get a little bit of basil, because I think basil will work well with that.
Very well. And what I'm going to do while you're doing that is another thing that we came up with is just a little bit of chili. So we've got a little bit of dried chili powder here, which I'm just going to put in a really, really small fine sieve. And then just a little few taps. Don't go too hard. It's just going to give it a nice little heat at the back of the palate.
Chili and chocolate.
Oh, mate.
Great combination.
Best mate.
So I've got some little pansies as well.
Yep.
That I found.
And basil.
And then some basil. I'll put some basil on there.
I would be super happy if I were you, Benny. This is looking a really nice one.
It's come out beautifully. I'm happy with that. What are we going to call it?
It's got to be Black Forest meets Mexico. Something like that. That's exactly what it is.
That'd sell on a menu, wouldn't it?
Definitely, especially if it looked like that.
Should we try it?
I'm excited.
Now, I've deliberately made it not as sweet for you.
Yeah, there's very, very little sugar in
there. There's no sugar.
There's only sugar in those biscuits.
Yeah, we haven't added any sugar at all. So
it's all about, I'm going deep.
You want some of that cream.
Well played.
Oh,
it's
that's
beautiful because it's balanced.
Yeah.
It's not too sweet. You get the acidity from the lime. Mm. You get a nice little salt kick. You get that little bit of, how's it going? Down the back of the palate.
At the end.
Chili. Yeah.
And those bursts of the cherries.
Yeah. Really, really good.
I'm proud of that one.
Well done.
You can have it if you want. We can share that recipe.
No, I thought you meant this.